Peugeot builds its RCZR engines in the town of Arimoncourt in eastern France. The cylinders are lubricated to prepare for the installation of the pistons. The piston is collected, checked to ensure it has all of its components, and then slid into a device that compresses the piston rings. A yellow netting prevents the piston from damaging the cylinder as it's inserted. Once all four cylinders have been installed, the engine block is cranked 180 degrees, so the other end of the bore holes are accessible, ready for the next phase of assembly. A series of large bolts are loosened and removed. This allows the crankcase cover to be lifted off. One by one, all the crankcase bearings are carefully installed. The piston rod caps are carefully removed. With the crankcase fully prepared, a lifting device is used to bring the crankshaft to the block and lower it into place. The piston rod caps are placed over the crankshaft and tightened to hold them in place. The crankshaft is turned, so the other pistons are accessible. A bespoke tightening device gives the bolts the precise torque prescribed by the engineers. In order to ensure proper thread alignment, before tightening, the device first turns in reverse. The crankcase cover is repositioned. The cover has a bead of silicone around its perimeter to help seal the joint. Again, a pre-programmed device is used to tighten the bolts on the crankcase to a specified torque setting. The cover goes over the oil pump sprocket and chain. The oil pump's cover is lowered into position and checked to make sure it's aligned. The cover is bolted securely in place with a torque-controlled power driver. The cylinder head gasket is carefully positioned over the cylinders. The cylinder head is brought back to the cylinder block, aligned perfectly with the help of a guide dowel and lowered into position. A torque control device linked to a monitor digitally guides a technician through a prescribed fastening pattern. The cylinder head is then secured to the engine block. The cylinder head already has all of its components installed, including the valves, push rods, rocker arms, and two camshafts. A plastic guide helps with the lowering and installation of the timing chain and sprocket. The camshaft sprockets are inserted next to it. The gear teeth are aligned, and the timing chain is looped over both and temporarily secured with a handheld ratchet driver. The crankshaft hub is installed in its position. Now the cover can be placed over the cylinder head and bolted into place. The composite plastic cover contributes to the car's low overall weight. The same is true for the exhaust manifold. The car's curb weight is just 1,280 kilograms. Finally, the engine's twin-scroll turbocharger is mounted on the cylinder head. It's now time to fire up the engine and check it works. The engine is started and check for any signs of leaks. This system will detect any flaws in the engine's performance. The positioning tool helps when it comes to attaching the flywheel to the crankshaft. The clutch mechanism is installed using a compression tool, and the assembly is screwed in place following a precise tightening sequence. The engine is carefully examined, both visually and manually. Everything is checked, from the serial number, to the fuel levels, to the electrical connections. Generate 270 horsepower from just a four-cylinder engine, every detail has been optimized. resulting in a sports car that's both capable of competing on track and also competing in the daily commute.